वंदेहं श्रीगुरु.
The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 27th of April, 1974, in Hyderabad, India.
Sri Rupam Chakrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tvam Sajivam.
ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय.
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 श्री भगवान वाच.
श्री भगवान वाच.
मैया सक्त मना पात.
मैया सक्त मना पात.
योगं युञ्जन्मदाश्रयः.
योगं युञ्जन्मदाश्रयः.
संशयं समग्रं माम.
संशयं
समग्रं माम.
यथा
वेक्षसि तच्छृणु.
श्रीभगवान् उवाच.
श्रीभगवान् उवाच.
मय्या
सक्त मना प्रार्थ.
योगं
युञ्जन्मदाश्रय.
संशयं समग्रं माम.
संशयं समग्रं माम.
यथा ज्ञास्यसि तच्छृणु.
यथा ज्ञास्यसि तच्छृणु.
श्री भगवान् उवाच.
श्री भगवान् उवाच.
मय्या सक्त मनाः पात.
मय्या सक्त मनाः पात.
योगं युञ्जन्मदाश्रय.
योगं युञ्जन्मदाश्रय.
संशयं समग्रं माम.
असंशयं समग्रं माम. यथा ज्ञास्यसि तच्छृणु.
Translation. Now hear, O son of Pritha, Arjuna, how by practicing yoga in full consciousness of me, with mind attached to me, you can know me in full, free from doubt.
Sri Bhagavan Uvacha. मैया सक्त मना पार्थ योगं युञ्जन् मदाश्रय असंशयं समग्रं माम यथा ज्ञास्यसि तच्छृणु. इन द ह्यूमन सोसाइटी इट इज ए प्रेरोगेटिव टू नो गॉड. इन द एनिमल सोसाइटी देर इज नो सच क्वेश्चन. दे Human society is meant for understanding what is God. That is the privilege of human being. We come to this form of human being after many, many births. There are 8,400,000 species of life, beginning from water, then on the land, in the water there are 9 lakh species of life, different aquatics. So, in the beginning of creation, the whole planet was merged into water. That is also scientific and modern science. And from shastras also we understand Pralaya payadhi jale dhita banasi bhedam kesavadhita meena sarira jaya jagadhi sahare. So, in the beginning, there was water. So there must be living entities, because living entities are everywhere, in the water, in the air, on the land, within the water, everywhere. Therefore, the living entities are called sarvaga. Sarvaga means the living entity can go anywhere. As we are now trying to go to the moon planet, so we may go or not go, but there are living entities in all the planets, in different positions. There are innumerable planets and innumerable universes also. And beyond this material world, there is another nature, parastasmatu bhava anya bhaktya bhaktya sanatana. That nature is permanent. This material nature is not permanent. It is bhutta bhutta praliyate. Everything here in the material world, everything comes into existence, takes birth, janma, then stays for some time, grows the body, then produces some byproducts, then dwindles and then fades. This is the material nature. Just like your body, my body, it has taken birth at a certain date. It is growing and it is producing some children, byproducts. Then as we are growing old, then one day the body will be finished. This is the material nature. Either you take it personally, individually, your body, or this gigantic body of the universe. In whichever way you may take it, the nature is bhutta bhutta praliyat. Here the material nature is you take your birth or appearance and again disappear and again appear. This is the instruction of spiritual life. The spirit soul is there, but it is not getting a permanent settlement. This is material world. Tatha dehantara prati. As the body is changing, there are so many children, they will also become old like me, but the spirit soul is there. In the presence of mother, although the body is changing, the mother knows that my son is there. Although from babyhood the son has grown to boyhood, the original body, child's body, baby's body, not existing, the mother knows that my boy is there. So this is common sense understanding. People do not understand it. Very nice common sense that the body is changing, but the soul is there. Exactly the same example. The mother knows that my boy, my child, although he has changed body, now he is grown up, say 50 years old, but my child is, he is my child. Where is the difficulty to understand? Anyone can understand, but people do not believe in the transmigration of the soul. Jashatu buddhi kunapiti dhatuke. This kind of education, what is the value? The real knowledge begins when we understand that we are not this body, material body. I am different from body. Dehi nasmin jatha dehi kovaram jauvananga jara. Tatha dehantara prati dhirastatva navayati. This is our position. Then, when you understand that I am not this body, I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi, then real knowledge begins. Otherwise, so long we are in the bodily concept of life, we are animals. The first education should be given to the students, that he is not this body, he is spirit soul. And because he is spirit soul, he has got a different business than to maintain this body. Maintenance of the body, that is being done by the cats and dogs also, they also take care of the body very nicely. They fight, struggle for existence, they fight to keep the body fit. The tiger also, he fights, he secures his eatables by fighting. Similarly, this struggle for existence to get things for eating, sleeping, mating and defending, that is current in the animal society also. So, Śāstra says therefore, nāyaṁ deha deho bhājaṁ niloke kastāna kāmān arhativīr bhujāṁ ji. Śāstra says, ayaṁ deha, this body, human body, nāyaṁ deha niloke, deho bhājaṁ niloke. Niloke means in the human society. The animals, nāyaṁ deho deho bhājaṁ niloke, kastāna kāmān ahrati bhīr-bhujāṁ. Bhīr-bhujāṁ means an stool-eater animal. Stool-eater animal, hog. You know, although it is not very easily found in the cities, in our Indian villages, there are so many stool-eater hogs loitering in the street, in the village. The only business is where to find out stool. This is the business. Whole day, night they are working to find out stool. See, if human being is educated to find out his eatables, of course the hog's eatables are the stool. They like it very much, very palatable thing. Similarly, we also, for some palatable things, we also work day and night. But Śāstra says, na ayaṁ deha deha bhājaṁ niloke kastāṁ kāmān arhati. Why this human society should be trained up to work so hard simply for eating, sleeping, mating and defending? This is not good. Then what is it meant for human life? Tapo, tapasya. Tapo dibbaṁ jena suddheta satya. See, the human life's business is to accept tapasya, voluntarily accepting some inconvenience of life. That is called tapasya. Tapo means some trouble, just like to become brahmachari. It is tapasya, just like we are prescribing this formula. No illicit sex, no intoxication, no meat eating, no gan. People want to do it. People want illicit sex. The whole city is full of pictures, simply how to indulge in illicit sex. Then meat eating, big signboard, and intoxication, wine shops, they want it. That is the natural propensity. Loke bhave amisha madya seva nityasra jantu nahi tatra chodana. You do not require to encourage them in these things. They have got natural tendency. That is material world. To enjoy unrestricted sex life, to eat meat, fish, eggs, amisha, amisha madya seva. Amisha means eat meat, fish, eggs. These are amisha. And vegetarian means niramisha. So amisha madya seva. Madya means intoxication. Either wine or cigarette or bidi or ganja, bhang, teas, coffees. They are all intoxications. So amisha madya seva and babaya. Babaya means sex life. You do not require to educate them. In the school, college, the boys and girls are not given lesson. Of course, I think they are now given lesson also. But naturally, without any lesson, they know how to do it. Similarly, without an education, one can take to intoxication. So these things are natural. But when we try to stop these material instincts. That is called tapasya. So human life is not to be carried away by the so-called natural instinct. Natural instinct, material life, there are two kinds of natural instinct. So long we are in the bodily concept of life, there are different natural instincts, and when we come to the platform of spiritual understanding, that natural instinct is different. That is real natural instinct. So that natural instinct, spiritual natural instinct, can be attained by tapasya. Tapodibbam, that is the instruction of Vishabdev. Now people may say, then why we should undergo this tapasya, austerities? If we want to enjoy life, why we shall voluntarily give up this and undergo austerities? No, there is reason. Kapo divvam jena suddheta satya jasmad brahma saukham anantam. It's very reasonable. You have to undergo tapasya, voluntarily restrain. That is called tapasya. So why na jato suddheta satya? Your existence will be purified. What is the wrong in my existence? Or that we cannot understand, that is called illusion. There are so many wrong things. Always we are in miserable condition. This summary miserable condition is as described in the Bhagavad Gita. Janma mittu jara vyadhi dukkha dosanu darsanam. That is intelligent. That I am now put under, although I have solved all my problems. But Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, you have solved all your problems by your so-called scientific advancement, that is all right. But where is your solution of janma mittu jara vyadhi? Repetition of birth, death, old age and disease. Where is your solution? This is very intelligent question. Krishna says, therefore, that you have solved all the problems of miserable condition of life, that is all right. But you should always keep in front these problems, prominently. Janma mittu jara vyadhi dukkha dosanu. Janma, the tribulations of janma, to live within the womb of the mother. Everyone who had suffered, but you have forgotten. Similarly, we are awaiting another suffering at the time of death. That is also suffering, janma mittu. Then when we take birth, we get old. That is also suffering, and we suffer from diseases. But as we are spirit soul, that is described in the Bhagavad Gita, na hannate hannamane sarire. The spirit soul does not die after the annihilation of this body. That is our position. We are accepting different types of bodies. But we are eternal, part and parcel of the Supreme. Not only eternal, full of knowledge and blissful. This is our position. But at the present moment, because we have got this body, it is not very pleasurable condition. It is miserable condition. There are adhyatmik, adhi bhautik, adhi daivik, miseries. And always we are under. That we cannot understand. We are thinking that things go on like this. Don't bother about these things. Go on, eat, drink, me, marry, enjoy. That means we are living very foolishly. Although the problems are there, I do not wish to die. The death is there. I do not wish to be within the womb of my mother, but I am forced to take a body within the womb of my mother. Then when I get the body, I come out, I am subjected to so many tribulations on account of this body, old age, disease and so many. So actually this is the problem of living entities. That knowledge can be acquired in the human form of life, and it can be solved. Not that simply we get the knowledge, but it can be solved. So, therefore, real business of human life to understand oneself, that is called self-realization, brahma-bhuta, and find out the remedy and act accordingly, that is the mission of human life. Not like to dance like cats and dogs with a nice dress. That is not human life. This is the subject matter of Bhagavad Gita. Our whole Vedic instruction. Vedaishta sarvai aham eva vedam. This is God consciousness, Krishna consciousness, or self-realization. Self-realization means either you see yourself or see the Supreme Lord. Either way. But without seeing the Supreme Lord, you cannot see yourself. Just like without seeing the sun in the darkness, just like it is now night, there is no sun. So I cannot see also. In darkness I cannot see also myself. But when there is sun in the morning, I can see the sun and I can see myself. This is the theory. So if we want to understand ourselves, right, that I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi, then we must take to Krishna consciousness. Now how one can take to Krishna consciousness, that is being described by Krishna in the seventh chapter of Bhagavad Gita. First verse is, maya saptamana pratha jovang junyan madasre asam sam samagrang vang jatha gasasi tatha. Because we have to see God. Just like I told you, if you see the sun, then automatically you see everything. You see yourself, you see your neighbor, you see the city, you see the house, you see everything you can see when there is sunlight. Similarly, if you can see God, then you can see everything. Jasmin vijñāte sarvamedam vijñātam bhavanti. If you can understand what is God, then you understand everything. Now why don't you take this process to understand God? And that is the prerogative of human life, to understand God. Why you deny the existence of God? How you can deny? You cannot deny. There is a controller, supreme controller that we have to accept. We are not free. We are being controlled. However, we are trying to become independent of any controller. But that is not possible. Prakriti, you are under the control of the prakriti. Prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvas. Ahankara vimuratma karta aham iti mannate. Rascals and fools, they are thinking that we are independent. They are completely under the grip of the material nature. Everyone of you know, we want to do something. We don't want excessive heat. Why there is excessive heat? So that we have to manufacture this fan and air condition, so many things. This is simply a struggle against the control of the material nature. This is a fact. And we have to accept this. You cannot deny it. That is described. Prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa. Ahankara vimuratma kartaham itiman. Those who are fools and rascals, they are thinking we are independent. You are not independent. Under the prakriti, under the nature. And what is the prakriti? Prakriti is the agent or agency of Krishna. That is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Mayadhakshena prakriti suyatesa characharam. Under my control. Prakriti is controlling you or me. And prakriti is being controlled by Krishna. Therefore Krishna is the supreme controller. That is accepted in the Vedic literature. Ishara parama Krishna satchidananda vigraha. Krishna is controller, we are surprised. How? I am also a human being and Krishna is also a historical person, human being. How he is controller of the whole material nature? That is answer. Satchidananda vigraha. Although he comes as a person, but he is not a person like us. He is Sachidananda Vigraha. That you can understand studying. What is that Sachidananda Vigraha? Sat means eternal. Chit means full of knowledge. And Ananda means blissfulness. But so far my body is concerned, your body is concerned, they are not Sachidananda Vigraha. My body, your body will not exist. Therefore it is asat. It is not sat. My body, your body is full of ignorance. Therefore it is not chit. It is achit. And my body, your body is not at all pleasing. There are so many troubles. Therefore it is not ananda. Therefore Krishna's body is different from us. Therefore he is controlling. We think if Krishna has got a body, then he must have a body like us. Abhajananti mangamura. Manasim tanumasita. These murahs, rascals, because I appear before them to give them the lesson about God, what is God, these rascals think of me as one of them. This is rascal. Abhajananti mangamura manasim parambhavajana. That Sachidananda Vigraha can control the whole material nature, that they do not know. Param bhava majana. So, therefore, it is our duty to understand Krishna. What is the difficulty? Krishna is personally, God is personally explaining himself, what he is. And if we accept that, then where is the difficulty to understand God? Why you are making so much research work to find out God? God is canvassing at your door. Here I am. You try to understand me. Here I am explaining myself. No, no. We shall find out God somewhere else. This is called murha. Navanga duskitana murha prabhadante naradhama. Naradhama means not even ordinary knowledge of a human being. Lowest of the mankind. We are searching out what is God, and God is canvassing here. We do not accept. Therefore, naradhama. Why? Maya purita jnana. Because their knowledge has been taken away by the illusory energy. But one whose knowledge has not been taken away, just like Arjuna. Arjuna was personally instructed by Krishna. And how he accepts Krishna? He accepts Krishna. Parabrahma parangdhama pavitram paramam bhava. Purusham śāśvatam ādyam. Oh, Krishna, you are Parabrahma. Parabrahma. The word, there are two words, Parabrahma and Brahma. Aham Brahmasmi. That does not mean Aham Parabrahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi, I am also spirit soul, but not the supreme. Parabrahma is Krishna. I am also Ishara. Ishara means controller. You are also Ishara. Just like in this school, the teacher is Ishara in his class. He is controlling some students. I am controlling my disciples. I am also Ishara. Everyone can be Ishara. Everyone can be God. But we are using the word Godhead. Just like there are some clerks and there is head clerk. Similarly, we are all gods. The Mayavadi philosophy, they say everyone is God. That's all right. But you are not the head God. Head there, if there is God, there are so many gods, there must be one head God. That is our natural experience. Anywhere you go, there are so many people, but there is some leader, head. I had some talks with one Russian professor, Professor Kotovsky in Moscow. So we had long talks. At last I asked him, Mr. Kotovsky, I forgot to comrade, but I said, Mr. So what is the difference between your philosophy and my philosophy, or our philosophy? You have to accept one leader, a head, and we also accept one head. Then where is the difference between communism and otherism? So he was taught, he appreciated very much. The difference is that you have accepted Lenin as your head and we have accepted Krishna as our head. So there is no difference of the philosophy. You have to accept. Nitya nityanam chetanas chetananam. That is the Vedic instruction. What is meaning of God? God means the head of the living entities. What is the difficulty to understand it? Nitya nityanam chetanas chetananam. Nitya means eternal. We are also eternal. God is also eternal. So where is the difference? So qualitatively we are one. Because God is eternal, I am also eternal. I am now somehow or other in disease condition that I have to change my body. But God does not change his body. Sambhamami atmaya. He says, atmaya, by my own willpower. I am not forced. Just like according to my karma, I have been forced to accept this material body, certain type of body. I cannot dictate as I am creating another body by my karma. So the karma by Prakite Kriyamanani, another place, so why the living entities are getting different types of bodies? That is also answer. Karanam, the reason is Gunasanga Asya Sadasad Janma Junishu. Karanam, the cause is the material nature. The material nature is divided into three modes. Satogun, Tamogun, Rajog. So to become within the material nature, under the control of the material nature, means to accept one of these guna. Satogun, Rajogun, Tamogun. So if you accept the Satogun, the Brahminical qualification, Satya, Sama, Dama, Tidikha, Arjava, Kanti, Jnanam, Vijnanam, Astikam, Brahma, Karma, Sabha. If you associate with the Brahminical qualification, then you get nicer body. Urdhvam Gacchanti Sattvasthah. Those who are associating with the Sadguna, they are also described. Sadguna means Sattvam, Samam, Dhamam, Titikha, Arjava, Khanti, Jnanam, Vijnanam, Astikam, Brahmakarma. This is Brahmakarma. So tapasya means come to the Brahmakarma, not to the Shudra Karma. Karanam Guna Sangas. Don't associate with the Shudra qualification. Now, what is the Shudra qualification? Parichajjātmakam kārjam Shudra Karma Sabhāvajam. You are highly educated, but your desire is how to get a service. Parichajjātmakam, I am highly educated, but unless I render service to somebody else, like a dog, I am not recognized. This is called Shudra Karma. Why a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya should search after service? Therefore, in this Kali Yuga, it is said, Kalo Shudra Sambhava. Kalo, in this Kali Yuga, everyone is almost Shudras. There is lack of Brahmana. There is lack of Kshatriya and Vaishya. So, in Bhagavad Gita, we find all the solution of the human problems. All the solution. Chaturvarnam maya system gunakarma vibhagasa. Unless you divide the whole human society into four divisions, the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra, you must have to divide. You cannot say classless society, that is useless society. Classless society means useless society. There must be an intelligent, high-class, ideal class of men to see that here is human civilization. That is Brahman. Chaturvarnam maya system gunakarma. Unless people see the ideal man, how they will follow? Jajjad acharati sreshtha lokastat anuvartat. The Brahmana is compared with the brain of the body. Unless there is brain, what is the use of these hands and legs? If one's brain is cracked, mad, he cannot do anything. So at the present moment, because there is scarcity of brahminical qualified men in the whole human society, it is not meant, Brahman is not meant for, simply for India or Hindus, for the whole human society. Krishna never said that the Chaturmanang Maya Srishta is meant for India or for Hindus or for a class. For whole human society, there must be a very ideal, intellectual man, so that people will follow. Brain of the society. That is the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. You cannot say that we can do without brain. Suppose from your body, if the brain is cut off, your head is cut off, then you are finished. What the hands and legs will do if there is brain? There is no brain. So at the present moment, there is scarcity of brain in the whole humanity. Therefore it is in the chaotic condition. So there is need, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, the human society, the whole human civilization must be reformed in this way, that there are intellectual class of men, naturally. There are first class intellectual class of men, second class intellectual, third class, fourth class, like that. So the first class intellectual men, they must be brahmanas. In the brahmanical qualification, and they must be Krishna conscious, then they can guide the whole society in the right way and there will be no problem. This is Krishna consciousness movement. So here Krishna says, how to become Krishna conscious? That is for the Brahmin or the intellectual class of man. That is being described by Krishna. What is that? Maya Saktamana. The mind should be attached upon me, Krishna. This is the beginning. Somewhere or other, our mind is attached to something else. Mind cannot be detached. We have got so many desires. Mind's business to become attached. Therefore, I accept something, I reject something. This is mind's business. So you cannot become zero. You cannot become desireless. That is not possible. Our process, just like others, they say, you become desireless. That is a foolish proposal. Who can become desireless? It is not possible. If I am desireless, then I am a dead man. A dead man has no desire. So that is not possible. We have to purify the desires. That is required. Purify the desires. Sarvopadhi vinir muktam tat paratena nirmalam. This is called purification, nirmalam. Tat paratena. Tatparattam means when God conscious, Krishna conscious, then desires become purified. So we have to come to the point of not desirelessness, but to the point of purified desire. That is point. Therefore here it says, Mayasakta mana. You cannot make your mind desireless, but you fix up your mind upon me. That is equal. Maya sakta mana prartha. This is the yoga system. This is called bhakti yoga. And this is called first class yoga. That is described in the Bhagavad Gita. That yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaratmana. The yogi, the first class yogi, yoginam api sarvesam. There are different kinds of yoga system. But the person who has accepted this bhakti yoga, he is thinking of me always. Just like these boys and girls, they are being taught, always thinking of Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So if you read Bhagavad Gita and chant Hare Krishna, immediately you learn the whole science, how to become attached with Krishna. This is called Maya Saktamana. Maya Saktamana Prartha. Yogang Junjan. To practice yoga. This is bhakti yoga. Madasraya. Madasraya means under my direction or under my protection. Asraya. So if you read Bhagavad Gita as it is, that is madasraya. But if you interpret Bhagavad Gita according to your rascal imagination, that is not Bhagavad Gita. Therefore it is called madasraya. Under my protection, as I am thinking. We are therefore presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is. We do not change. Why you should change? What right you have got to change? If Bhagavad Gita is a book of authority, and if I make my own interpretation, then where is the authority? Can you change the law book according to your interpretation? Then what is the meaning of that law book? That is not law book. You cannot change. Similarly, if you accept Bhagavad Gita as the book of authority, you cannot change the meaning. Then that is not allowed. What right? If you have got some opinion, if you have got some philosophy, you can write in your own book. Why you are killing others and yourself by interpreting Bhagavad Gita? You give your own thesis in a different way, but these people, they take advantage of the popularity of Bhagavad Gita and interpret in a different way according to their own whims. Therefore, people do not understand what is Krishna. That is the difficult. And the purpose of Bhagavad Gita is to understand Krishna. And all the so-called scholars and politicians' commentary is to banish Krishna or to kill Krishna. The Kamsa's policy. The Kamsa was always thinking of Krishna, how to kill him. That is called demonic endeavor. So that will not help you. Therefore Krishna says, you have to develop your love and attraction for Krishna. That is what. Maya sakta mana prat. Yogam junyan madasra. This yoga practice can be performed madasraya, under my protection or my devotee's protection. You cannot take protection of another rascal who interprets Bhagavad Gita in a different way. You have to take shelter directly. Of course, Bhagavad Gita instruction is there. Everyone can take shelter of Krishna directly. Where is the difficulty? Just like here it is said, Maya Sakta, you have to develop your attachment for Krishna. You can do that. How these Americans and Europeans boys, they have developed their attraction for Krishna. There is a process. If you adopt this process, they are with me for the last 2, 3, or 4 years. Now you detach them from Krishna consciousness if you have got any power. You cannot do that. Even you bribe them, or what you can do? Their father, mother, their countrymen can give you enough. They are all rich man's sons. But they cannot give up Krishna consciousness. Even the Christians, priests, they regret that these are our boys. And they never came to church. They never like to understand what is the idea of God. Now these same boys, they are after, mad after God. What is this movement? They are surprised. So there is a process. If we adopt that process, then everyone can become Maya Saktamana, Krishna Saktimana. We have to adopt the process. That process is called Yogam Yunyan Madasra. You have to accept the yoga system under the protection of Krishna, personality, or his bona fide devotees, represented. Then he will be. Then what will be the result? The result will be asangsayam, without any doubt. Now people are educated in all other institutions about God, but they are all full of doubts. Full of doubts. What kind of God? What is the nature of God? Whether there is God? Where there is no God, so many doubts. But if you accept this Krishna consciousness yoga system, then you understand Krishna asangsayam, without any doubt, and samagram in fullness, not that partial. Partially understanding of God, that is also understanding, but it will again take time, because unless you fully understand what is God, you cannot go back to home, back to God. That is the problem. There are different stages or phases of understanding that is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaneti sabdat. Badanti tat tattavidas tatyam. The absolute truth is that it is one, but it is realized into different phases. As Brahma, as Paramatma, and as Bhagavan. So if you understand Brahma, that is also partial understanding. If you understand Paramatma, Brahma is understood by the philosophical speculation, Mayavad philosophy, or Jnana Marga, then you can understand partial, just like to understand the sunshine is partial understanding of the sun. It is not full understanding. Full understanding, if you have got power to go to the sun globe to see the predominating deity there, Vibhushan, the sun god, then it is full understanding. If you think that understanding the sun sign, you have understood the whole feature of the sun globe, that is wrong. Similarly, to understand Brahma, impersonal Brahma, is also partial understanding. And to understand Paramatma, Ishvara Sarvabhutanam Riddhesi Arjuna Tishtati, that is also little higher step, but that is also partial. But when you understand Bhagavan, the Supreme Personal, that is full understanding. Therefore, it is said, Bhagavan Ubhacha, full understanding. Vyasadeva could have said Krishna Ubhacha, but because Krishna is understood wrong way sometimes by the fools understand, therefore he says directly, Bhagavan Ubhacha. You cannot question the statement or instruction of Bhagavan. Bhagavan means opulence. There are six kinds of opulences. Bhagavan means one who is full with six kinds of opulence. So nowadays there are so many Bhagavan, but because they have no full opulences, they cannot be accepted as Bhagavan. Bhagavan means full opulence. Aishajasya samagrasya, bijasya, jasasya sriya, jnana vairagya chaiva, sara iti bhagangana. Full opulence, complete wealth, complete strength, complete beauty, complete knowledge, complete renunciation. One who possesses all these six things completely, he is Bhagavan. Bhagavan is not so cheap thing that it can be found in the lanes and the streets and roads. So that is also another misunderstanding. Therefore, Vyasadeva says, Sri Bhagavan Ubhacha. He is complete in everything. Ishvara Parama. Ishvara means controller. Parama means supreme. No more, better than that. That also enunciated by Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita. Matta parataram nanya. There is no more superior element than me. So, if you study Bhagavad Gita, if you understand what is the nature of Bhagavan, then our life is successful. Asaṃsaṃ samagraṃ māṃ yathāgāśya sitāśiṣu. So Krishna is describing himself. You try to understand from the statement of Krishna, with your logic, argument, science and everything, you'll find complete answer. So this Krishna consciousness movement is not concoction of mind. It is scientific. It is based on the Vedic knowledge. It is primarily on the background of the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. If we take to this Krishna consciousness, then our human life, its mission will be successful. That is our request to you all. Thank you very much. Difficulty is that when you are admitted into some school, if you accept the regulation of the school, then you make progress. And from the very beginning, if the student says, why shall I do this? Then there is no question of making progress. If the teacher says, that write A like this, like B like this, and if the student protests, why shall I write this? Why not this way? Why not this way? Then how will make progress? So our difficulty in this country, they have learnt everything. Although they are rascal number one, that is the difficulty. When we put Krishna, here Krishna says, and Shastra says, Krishna is the Bhagavan Sam. All these people will come forward, why Krishna shall be the Bhagavan? I have got another Bhagavan. That is the difficulty. But these poor people, they have no idea of another Bhagavan. So I am speaking to them, Krishna is the Supreme Personality. They are accepting and making progress. This is difficult in this country. Krishna says, we are very much proud of reading Bhagavad Gita, but you don't accept Bhagavan as Krishna as the Supreme Bhagavan. This is our difficulty. Krishna says, Matta Paratanam Nanya. There is no more superior. element than me. So why we shall accept Krishna? Krishna says, sarvadhanman parityajya mamekam saranam bhaja. The so-called scholars, it is too much. Why? This is the difficulty. They read Bhagavad Gita, but they read in their own way. And the purpose is to kill Krishna. That is the difficulty. Kamsa's philosophy. Kamsa was always thinking of Krishna, Krishna conscious. But what is the thinking? How to kill Krishna? That is demonic. The demons, they also think of God. That is the movement, you take it. Krishna consciousness. The Rama and Krishna the same. Rama dinuttisu kalaniyamena tishthan. Krishna sang samabhavat paramapumanaju. Govindamadi purusam tamaham. We don't distinguish between Rama and Krishna. Rama is the Supreme Lord, Krishna is also the Supreme Lord. Rama dinuttisu kalaniyamena, not only Rama. There are so many other forms of Krishna. They are mentioned in the Shastra. That is summarized in the Srimad Bhagavatam. That all the names of God, incarnation mentioned here, enlisted. But Krishnastu Bhagavan sa. The name Krishna, that he is the supreme original personality of God. Yes? No, guna karma. Just like engineer is by his qualification and by his work. Suppose a man is qualified as an engineer, so he should be accepted as engineer. But if he does not work as engineer, then also he will not be accepted as engineer. If he simply passed engineering qualification and sit down at home, nobody will go to consult him. If you work as engineer and you have got the qualification of engineer, then you are engineer. Similarly, one must possess the qualification of Brahmana, the qualification of Kshatriya or Vaishya, and he must act accordingly. Guna karma vibhava. Chatur bannang maya sista. Atapungvi dijas sreshta bannasama vibhava. Sanusthitasya dharmasya samsiddhi harito usana. As the different parts of the body, the head, the hand, the belly, the legs, all of them combined together, trying to serve this whole body. Similarly, there for convenience sake, there must be Brahminical class, Kshatriya class, Vaishya class, Shudra class, and all together they should maintain the whole body. Oh, that means the whole. Whole is Krishna. So everyone should be engaged in Krishna consciousness. But it doesn't matter for management of the society. There must be a first-class intellectual class, a first-class brave class who can defend the whole society, and there must be productive class, and there must be laborer class. This is very simple to understand. But everyone should be engaged for understanding Krishna consciousness. That is transcendental position. Everything is clearly described in the Bhagavad Gita. Yes? Yes. It has got a medicinal effect. That is described by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Cheta darpanam ajanam bhava mahadavagni nidvapanam sriya kairava chandrika vitaranam vidyavadhu jivanam anandam budhivadhanam prativadam purnam mritasadhanam parang vijayati Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. If you chant this Hare Krishna mantra, then all these things will come one after another. The first thing is cetadarpanamandham, cleansing of the heart. All rascal things are within our heart. If you chant, if you hear the vibration, because it is transcendental vibration, Krishna, the chanting and Krishna is not different, absolutely. Here in the material world, the name and substance are different. But in the spiritual world, this vibration is coming from the spiritual world. Golokera premadhana hari nama sankirtan. It is not manufactured within this material world. It is coming down from the spiritual world, just like some vibration comes, some news comes from other country. Similarly, it is from another nature, superior nature. Therefrom coming, it is down by parampara system. It is brought by Narad Muni. Because if you chant, say, this name is not different from Krishna. Therefore, chanting of Hare Krishna mantra means associating with Krishna directly. So, if you associate with Krishna, then you become purified. Cheta darpana mayajana. As soon as you have got clear consciousness, then bhavamadi, all the problems of this material world is finished. Brahma bhuta prasanna atma na sochati na kang. So this is the effect of chanting. Why don't you try it? Yes, you can chant Rama. Somebody chants like that. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. That does not make any. So you take Rama card. Thank you very much. All right, chant Hare Krishna. Yes, you want to ask something? Yes. Yes, therefore teaching this Krishna philosophy everywhere, so that they may take to the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita everywhere, and they are taking it. It will take some time. But this is necessary. Without taking this Krishna philosophy, you cannot be saved. Krishna disappeared. Yes. Yes. Yes, just to confuse you. Because you are thinking Krishna as human being, so he is confirming your attitude. Yes, I am human being, I am not God. Because those who thought Krishna as human being, just to keep them in that ignorance, Krishna did that. But it is stated also that Krishna went in his own chariot to Vaikuntha. So that means he is not killed like an ordinary human being.
It is useful to have different gods with different characteristics to suit varieties of people. Why force one god upon the people? It is like giving one coat and asking everyone to fit into it.
Yes, that is answered in the Bhagavad Gita. Kamastastha hitajnana jajanti anna devata. Antavattu phalam tesam tad bhavati alpamedhasa. To worship different demigods, that is not forbidden in the Vedic literature. But Krishna personally says that tad bhavati alpamedhasa. Those who are less intelligent, they are allowed. At least let them accept some authority. That is for alpamedhasam, less intelligent class of men. That's all. But when Krishna is advising why he should keep others less intelligent, he is personally advising him, sarvadharmān parityajyamāme kaṁsāra. He'll get everything. But the less intelligent class of men, they cannot understand it. Therefore they go to demigods. Kāmaśtaśta hitajñāna jajanti annadeva. Hitajñāna. And their intelligence is lost. If he can get something from some demigod, can he not get it from Krishna, the Supreme God? He can get it. That is advice in the Shastra. Akama sarokama ma moksha kama udaradhi tibrena bhakti yogena jajita paramam purus. Even if you are sarvakama, you have got so many desires, material, still you should worship Krishna. Because one day you come to Krishna consciousness by directly being attracted by Krishna. Just like Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj, he went to perform severe penances, austerities to get some land, wanted his father's property or better than that. But when he saw Krishna and Narayan, and Narayan wanted to give him benediction, whatever he liked, he said, Samin kitathosmi varangana jati. So, if you are desirous of something which you want to take from other demigod, you can ask it from Krishna. The benefit will be, you will see Krishna and you will be desireless or no more desires for material things. That will be a problem. But if you continue to get some temporary benefit of this material world, so you'll get it, but antavattu phalam tesam, with the end of your body everything is finished. Tad bhavati alpamedhasam. So this kind of worship is preferred by less intelligent class. Because they're blind, andha jathandhi rupaniyamana. One blind man is leading other blind man. So what will be the result? Andha nati vidu sartha gatinghi vishnu durasayaji buhirathamanina. अंधा जथांधी रूपणीयमाना स्त्रीपी स्वतंत्रा हृदाम निबध्या डोंट माइंड जस्ट लाइक आवर लीडर गांधी स्पोक्स सो मेनी थिंग्स बट ही वॉज स्किल्ड हिमसेल्फ दैट जस्ट सी व्हाट इज हिज पोजिशन मिस्टर पटेल वॉर्न हिम दैट आई एम हियरिंग सो मेनी थिंग्स डू नॉट गो इन द मीटिंग टूडे बट वॉलंटरली नो आई शैल गो एंड यू आर स्किल्ड So he did not know what is going to happen next moment. And he is our leader. Therefore the Shastra says, Andha, Jathandhi, Rupaniyamana. If it is fact with Mahatma Gandhi, then what is there with other leaders? You are such a great personality. Therefore, we should take lesson from the person, Bhagavan Ubacha. Take lesson from Bhagavan and be happy. That is our problem. Don't take lesson from Andha. That will not help. Bhagavan, that is one thing. All right. Chanting. Thank you very much.